Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how to create a template for almost any kind of document in almost any kind of application on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So there's a really old feature built into macOS that allows you to create template files, files that you could use to start a new document instead of starting a blank document. As an example here, let's just use TextEdit, a pretty simple app for creating text documents. Now I'm going to create a new document here, and let's say it's part of my job, I have to create documents that look like this all the time. So you can see here, if I always have to start with this as kind of my template, it would be nice to be able to start with this rather than a blank document and have to type all of this out. So let's save this first. And I'm just going to save it like a normal text edit file. I'm going to put it on the desktop. And let me close it. Now I'm going to go to this file and use File, Get Info, or Command I to bring up information about that file. Now at the top here under General, you'll see information about the file. If you don't see it, you have to click here to reveal it. There are two checkboxes here that will help us create a template from this file. The first one we're going to look at is called Stationery Pad. I'm going to check that and then close this. And now this file behaves differently when you double click it. So I'm going to double click it and you think it would just open that file. But in fact, this is what happens. It creates a duplicate of that file with the word copy after it. So I get report copy rather than just report. And then it opens that copy. So there's no danger of me overwriting the original report file. I'm starting with a brand new file that has all the contents of the original file. And this file is already saved. Now chances are I want to change the name of this. I can do that in many ways. For instance, I can click here and change the name there. Or go to File, Rename, and change it that way. Or I could just change it right here in the Finder. By using the Stationery Pad function, I guarantee that I won't accidentally use the original file. It'll stay in its pristine condition. Because sure, I could go and every time I want to use this template, select it, use File, Duplicate, or Command D to create a new version of it. Or without Stationery Pad selected, I could open it up and then remember each time to go to File and Duplicate, or hold the Option key down and do File Save As to save a copy. But if you do that every day, one day you're bound to accidentally save over the original file. So that's where that Stationery Pad checkbox comes in handy. But that's not the only way to do it. Notice that in the info window here, there's also Locked. Let's use that instead. Now when I double click to open this file, it opens the file just fine. But if I try to edit it, as soon as I make my first change, it's going to tell me it's locked and it's going to give me the chance to duplicate the file. So I could do that. Or if I wanted to, before I get to that, I could go to File and then Duplicate, or hold the Option key down and do File Save As and save a new copy of that file that's not locked. So this shifts where you do some of the work, but it's basically the same amount of work and it guarantees that you won't overwrite that original file. Now one of the advantages of locked over Stationery Pad is that when you have a Stationery Pad, you can still open it up from within TextEdit. I can go to File, Open, or just use the Open dialog when I first launched the app, open it up, and now I'm editing the original file. So it only actually creates the duplicate of the file if you double click it in the Finder. This could be a problem or it could be an advantage depending upon how you use the template file. Having the file locked instead of a Stationery Pad will guarantee that you can't easily change the original file no matter how you open it. But you could also select Stationery Pad first and then locked and get the benefits of both. So now with both of those checked, if you double click it to open, it creates a duplicate and you're editing the duplicate and you can change its file name. But if in TextEdit you go and open the file, you've opened it, but you can see here at the top it's locked. So now when I try to actually do something with it, it's going to force me to make a duplicate of the file or choose File and Duplicate or hold the Option key and choose Save As. Now a few notes about doing this. It makes sense to use it in an app like TextEdit where there's no built-in template functionality. But in something like Pages, there's a built-in template system and you could choose from an existing template or create your own. So here in Pages, I would simply create a document like this and then do File and then Save as Template and save it as a custom template that would then appear under My Templates here in the Template Chooser in Pages. A lot of more complex apps like Pages, Numbers, Keynote, and things like Microsoft Word already have template functionality built into it, so you don't really need to use this, but you still can. And some apps don't seem to allow you to use a stationary pad at all. For instance, here I've created a document in Pixelmator Pro. So it's just some sort of starting point for maybe some graphics I usually create. Now if I go and try to set this to stationary pad, you can see it's not allowed. But you can set it to locked. So setting it to locked is your only option there to create a template. Now if you're curious about why it's not allowed, well, the answer is simple. This isn't a file. Yeah, it looks like a file, but it's actually a folder filled with several files. You can tell that by control clicking on it, and you could see Show Package Contents. It's a folder type called a package. If I use that, you can see inside of rectangle.pxd is actually a file, another folder, and some other things in it. So if an app has a complex file type that it saves to that's actually a package folder, not an individual file, then you won't be able to set it to a stationary pad.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.